With the establishment of a fractional reserve banking system at the Federal Reserve, the very nature of money was transformed from intrinsic value to debt. Power was shifted from those that provided value to humanity to those that enslaved humanity with debt and death. No longer did harvesting the world's resources or adding value to them create wealth. Now, those that created the most debt created the most wealth. And these men knew that nothing creates more debt than war. Under this fractional reserve system, when debt is created, money is created. When debt is paid off, money is destroyed. When you truly grasp the enormity of that little idea, your world will never be the same again. When you take on any debt, you are literally creating money out of thin air and you are the collateral. They use your debt obligation to back the money they create. This is why the debt will never be paid off, for if it did, there would literally be no money left in the world. If you really think about this, it is even worse than that. If your debts create all of the money in the world, where then does the money come from to pay the debt back with interest? Your debt only creates the principal amount that then enters the economy, not the interest. The only way for the interest on the loan to be paid is that every year more debt has to be created in the excess of debt and interest accrued the year before. This is why the global debt creation is growing exponentially. It has to, or we would see a massive collapse. For if all the debt was paid off, there would not only be no money in existence, but the bankers would still say we owe the interest on all of the money, even though there's no money left.
The whole government is a Ponzi scheme.
It is insane that we have based all of human life off this sick system. What's even worse is the way that humanity is so completely ignorant of the way the world has gone so horribly wrong. This simple little fact of economics explains why we have a constant state of war, huge and growing wealth disparity, destruction of local communities, millions on antidepressants, systemic unemployment, the breakup of the family, riots, and even suicides like Robin Williams. Debt money is the rot behind all of it. Most men live lives of quiet desperation and go to their grave with their song still in them. Henry David Thoreau. Humanity is suffering under a monetary system that is rigged to keep us in a constant, unnatural, quiet panic. This is done to keep us so worried about the day-to-day struggle of our lives so that we never have the time to contemplate, much less change our way of life. The wealthy know this very well, and even recently, a billionaire hedge fund manager, Tom Steyer, was quoted as saying that Americans were not as sophisticated as the ultra-wealthy because, quote, everybody else, which is the 99.5% of the people whose lives are very busy and complicated and pressing, and they don't have a lot of time to think about the things that don't immediately impact themselves and their family, unquote. Well, Tom, if we did not have a rigged game that you and your crony capitalist buddies were not constantly stealing from us with bailouts, wars, and insider training, humanity would blossom. But we do have these cancerous parasites that produce nothing of any tangible value, and then have the nerve to talk down to the good people who are doing the best with what they have. If Tom Steyer was half the man he claims he is, he would tell the truth about the system that made him so wealthy and promote individual solutions to shield those individuals from the banking system's inevitable collapse. Most people that suffer under this system are in denial and think that this is just the way it is. Many in the anger phase protest against the cops, or puppet bankers and politicians. Or worse, in the bargaining phase, they support collectivist messiahs that vow to fix the collectivist problems. Hope and fear of this system are a purposeful waste of time, which then leads people to the depression phase of the awakening.
God Almighty!
The final phase of acceptance realizes that while the world is messed up, the solution is only in our hands and nowhere else. Without control of the money supply, every other sinister scheme simply would not exist. Their ability to create debt and therefore money out of thin air has empowered the worst in humanity. The solution is for individuals to stack real tangible wealth outside of this rigged casino. The fatal flaw of the need to constantly expand debt was the driving force of the American Empire as it dominated the world after the end of the Cold War. This went unchallenged as America's largest generation, the baby boomers, entered into their peak earning years, and they were the first generation to embrace debt. They rocked through the rest of the 90s consuming, going into debt, and throwing money at Wall Street. Then, the party crashed with the collapse of the tech bubble in the year 2000 and the Enron scandal. Suddenly, there was a leak in the American Empire's dam and something had to be done.
Somebody help me!
In the Sons of Liberty Academy, we covered the neocon project for a new American century, the Taliban ending the Anglo-American opium trade, Saddam selling oil for euros, the plan to dominate the grand chessboard of the world's energy resources, the building of the Homeland Police State, the $2.4 trillion missing from the Pentagon, and the false flag known as 9/11. There you will see that nothing that happens in this world happens accidentally.
I got a call one day from an attorney woman I knew, and she said, would you like to meet one of the Rockefellers? I said, sure, I'd love to. And we became friends, and he began to divulge a lot of things to me. So he said to me one night, he said that there's going to be an event there, and out of that event, you're going to see we're going to go into Afghanistan, so we run pipelines from the Caspian Sea. We're going to go into Iraq to take the oil and establish a base in the Middle East. And we're going to go into Venezuela and try and get rid of Chavez. And the first two they've accomplished, Chavez they didn't accomplish. And I said, you're going to see guys going into caves looking for people that they're never going to find. You know, he was laughing about the fact that you have this war on terror. There's no real enemy. He's talking about how by having this war on terror, you can never win it, because it's an eternal war, and so you can always keep taking people's liberties away.
The American Empire rolled over the rest of the world with lies about weapons of mass destruction and boogeymen in caves. The very profitable war machine was spun up, and once again, the worst in humanity partied on. Behind the scenes, the bankers knew that if the debt did not grow fast enough, they needed to drive down rates to prevent the system from becoming insolvent. This market manipulation took money created out of nowhere to buy bonds to drive down rates. We were now a market totally devoid of reality, just a market of constant intervention and rigging. This fueled a housing boom and a massive misallocation in capital to rampant consumerism. We did not build anything of value to improve the lives of humanity, no productive factories to provide jobs, no new technologies that saved resources and capital. No, we blew it on McMansions, Hummers, and iPhones. No other generation in the history of the world was able to consume so much and provide so little in return. All of this was once again fueled by the minions on Wall Street that not only drove down rates but made sure that anyone that was breathing could take on more debt and buy a house and all of the things to fill the American dream. We personally saw people who could not qualify for a used car a few years prior, now all of a sudden buying $500,000 houses and Mercedes. This could not happen if not for the minions on Wall Street selling all of this garbage debt all over the world. They would package up these garbage loans and create tranches that would polish the poo into securitized gold. Just like the world just laid down for the fake war on terror, they once again trusted America. Countries, institutions, and investors all over the world ended up as unwitting owners of this garbage debt of unemployed McMansion consumers. In the financial collapse of 2008, the world woke up. They woke up to see that they were married to a cancerous psychopath and needed a plan to get divorced. They connected the dots between America's dollar dominance and the global wars that they used to secure the world's resources and trading lanes. While Goldman Sachs targeted the rising economies of Brazil, Russia, India, and China as the next targets of Wall Street dominance, we were the first to recognize these nations as the anti-hegemon. We clearly saw that these nations had all suffered under the Anglo-American Empire, and despite having no cultural or ideological unity, they did stand in opposition to the Anglo-American Empire. 5 years later, it is now very clear that the anti-hegemon will stand in political, financial, and military opposition to the Anglo-American Empire and the lies, debts, and death they have spread over the last century. Americans too woke up and saw that when times were good, Wall Street rolled in the profits. And when times were bad, they threatened to take down everyone.
And a few members were even told that there would be martial law in America if we voted no.
In the wake of the 2008 financial crisis, for the average American, the world became very real. Nearly three decades of the American consumer dream suddenly changed. People lost money, foreclosed homes, lost their jobs, and became worse, disillusioned. As bad as the 2008 collapse was, the full-on terrible reality did not hit just then. People still had jobs, houses, and savings to lose. People had faith in the hope and the change of politicians and the omnipotence of the central bankers. As we will see in the final part of the Rise and the Fall of the Bankster series, the terminal phase is going to be brutal for everyone. There is no safety net, there is no more faith in the system, and the world will not be so gullible as it was in 2008.
Thank you again.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was the last question. Thank you very much for coming.
We believe that physical silver outside of this inevitable systemic collapse will save the individual from the collective hell that is coming. The Silver Shield series seeks to create historically significant designs that will create generational wealth to help establish abundant solutions in the next monetary paradigm. Please visit silvershieldcollection.com.